Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The National Broadcasting Company, in cooperation with the United States Treasury Department, takes special pleasure in bringing you today the second of a special series of concerts by the NBC Symphony Orchestra under the eminent conductor Arturo Toscanini. These concerts are being given to encourage all of us listening in to back the attack with United States war bonds and stamps. Canadian listeners, of course, are urged to purchase Canadian war-saving certificates. Our studio audience here in Radio City presents a colorful panorama of Army, Navy, Marine, and Coast Guard uniforms. For at Maestro Toscanini's express request, the audience for this and the concert next week is made up of the men and women of our armed services. During the intermission period of our concert, we shall have the pleasure of hearing a message from our guest speaker, the Honorable Robert P. Patterson, Acting Secretary of War of the United States. Now, our studio audience is expectantly awaiting the entrance of Arturo Toscanini from the wings. Here he is now, as he graciously acknowledges the warm ovation of our audience. In just a moment, he will lead the men of the NBC Symphony Orchestra in the most popular of all the works of the 19th century Viennese light opera composer Franz von Suppé, the brilliant Poet and Peasant Overture. Arturo Toscanini continues this United States Treasury concert by the NBC Symphony Orchestra with one of the colorful orchestral suites of Jules Massenet, the Alsatian Scenes. The suite is in four movements, titled respectively Sunday Morning, At the Tavern, Under the Linden Trees, and Sunday Evening. The Alsatian Scenes of Jules Massenet.
Thank you.
With the performance of Massenet's Alsatian Scenes, we've come to the halfway point in our United States Treasury concert by Arturo Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra. And so it's a privilege and a pleasure now to bring you our guest speaker on this occasion, the Honorable Robert P. Patterson, Acting Secretary of War of the United States. Mr. Patterson.
There is nothing more calculated to inspire personal humility in a public speaker than to follow Mr. Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra on the air. The conflict in which we are now engaged as a nation is not a new one. It is as old as human aspiration. On one side are the cynical slave masters who hold man in contempt. On the other side are the champions of freedom, who believe in man's dignity and man's destiny. We have chosen our side. Great music cannot live behind barbed wire, and free thought will not long survive the concentration camp. In the long and distinguished career of Mr. Toscanini, no accomplishment, no deed of courage shines so brightly as his refusal to put his art at the disposal of tyrants. His decision drove him from his homeland. We in America have welcomed him as another champion of liberty. We now claim him as our own. And when freedom and the cause of freedom echo nobly through his music, we can truthfully say with Mark, with Walt Whitman, "I hear America singing." All over the world, on this summer afternoon, the cause of freedom is singing and marching. In the Mediterranean and in the far Pacific, the soldiers of the United Nations are pushing the enemy steadily back. From the southern shores of Sicily, a steady procession of men and tanks and guns moves toward the changing battlefront. Our ships dominate the sea, and our planes are masters of the air. We have had good news, and we shall have more good news, but the cost will be high. The Axis cannot be beaten without a heavy toll of young men's lives. Our duty here at home is plain enough. We must back up the men who are fighting and dying with every ounce of our energy. We must labor on the farms to produce food. We must labor in factories to produce more and more war supplies. We must endure inconveniences without grumbling. And we must dig deep into our pockets to buy war bonds. War bonds buy the airplane, the landing boats, the equipment which to the soldier in the field means the difference between victory and defeat. Already in this war, we here in America begin to see dimly the prospect of a calmer and happier future. A fraternity of freedom-loving nations is being born. Pray God the time will come when the lot of the common man everywhere will be more than a dark night and an ill guide, a boisterous sea and a broken cable, a hard rock and a rough wind.
Thank you, Mr. Patterson. In just a moment, our concert will resume with music by the 19th century Italian composer Giovanni Bolzoni. Known chiefly as the composer of the celebrated minuet in B major, Bolzoni also wrote three operas, a symphony, a number of smaller orchestral works, and much chamber music. Here is his serenade, the medieval castle serenade of Bolzoni. Thank you. We come now to music by the immortal Waltz King of Vienna, Johann Strauss, who said of his own masterpieces in 3/4 time, "If I may be said to have any talent whatsoever, I owe it all to my beloved native city of Vienna." Arturo Toscanini conducting the NBC Symphony.
Thank you.
won't delay in telling you what the next selection is by Arturo Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra. It is the overture to The Merry Wives of Windsor by Carl Nicolai. Maestro Toscanini.
Thank you.
And with the playing of the sparkling overture to the Merry Wives of Windsor, Arturo Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra have brought to a close this special concert presented jointly by the National Broadcasting Company and the United States Treasury Department.